Hatching and gradients. The term hatching refers to filling bounded areas with solid patterns and or gradients. You can hatch in the AutoCAD program to indicate transitions between materials and to improve the readability of the drawing in general. Hatching with solid fill patterns and or tonal gradients can transform simple line drawing into attractive illustration. Here is a sample examples for us also. Here we are having some respective patterns, whatever we have selected to fill up one boundary, closed boundary. Also we can make a solid fill, also we can go for a gradient fill also. So it will make our drawing more effective for the illustration and more attractive and easy to understand that what kind of material will be there in the bounded boundaries. So let us go for one example and demonstration to show you that how these hatch commands can be used and gradients can be used in our AutoCAD drawing. So here is the demonstration for you.
Here we are going to discuss the command hatch. So to initiate hatch, we shall have to type H. And whenever the hatch mode is there, we are having one tab that is hatch creation with multiple panels with the respective panel buttons. So let us suppose I want to make this particular area getting filled up with some hatch pattern. So we are having so many different patterns are there, so many different patterns you can check. You can also get a list. We can also get a list. So these are the patterns which you can select. Let us suppose I am going to select this respective pattern here. So that's why you are going to get a preview. Until and unless you click here, you are going to get a preview only. So before applying this one, you are going to get a preview. Now if you want to increase this distance between these lines, so here you can increase the distance. I'm making this one as 2. So as a result of that, the increase of distance has taken place. If I make this one as 1, then obviously the distance will be reduced. So in this way you can do it. Also we can have the angle. This is the angle which is having 0 degree. So if I make this one, this angle as say 45, then obviously this pattern will be rotated for the 45 degree accordingly. So if I make this one 90, then the pattern will be rotated accordingly. So in this way we can change the distance between this pattern lines, and we can also change the respective angle. Not only pattern, we are having other options like solid. So if you go for the solid, we are having this respective pattern. So now this pattern is actually solid fill, so I can change the color. If I require to do so, I can change the color accordingly. This is the color. Otherwise we can also go for gradient. If you select gradient, so here we are having multiple different options are there. So we are having different options are there for gradient. Let us suppose I am selecting this one. So if we apply this one, then I shall have to click only. Otherwise you are in a preview mode. You are in a preview mode. So in this way the gradients are there. You can change the color of this gradient. So you can change the color. So now I'm clicking in 4 respective zones. I'm clicking there in the 4 respective zones and they are getting colored accordingly. Now coming out from this hatch creation. Also we can initiate our hatch again issuing the command H. So this is the respective zone I'm going for. Say I'm having this respective pattern. So with the color this and with the angle 0. So in this way we have done it. So at the same time we can also put the pattern in multiple zones also. So I'm going for close. Now I want to show you that if I want to change this applied hatch pattern, how to do that one. You shall have to select this one, go for right click and go for hatch edit. Here you'll be getting all the options available. Let us suppose I'm going for the scaling of say 1.5 and go for OK. So this line distance has got increased. So now I'm selecting this one and going for right click and go for hatch edit. So in this case, I can change also the pattern here. I can change the angle. I'm making this one say 45. So in this way, in case of hatch edit, we are having multiple different options. You can easily explore them, and then the updates will be reflected on this respective pattern, whatever we have got selected. Let us suppose I'm changing the pattern also. So in this way, I have done. Now let us suppose I want to copy this pattern type to on other hatch patterns. So that is the match property. So I'm just selecting this one. I'm going for match properties, and then I'm selecting it. You can find that. You can easily find that this particular zone has got the same effect as it is having. So it is known as match property. So that means one zone's property can be copied onto the other zone. In this way, also we can apply the match property. And as I have told you that this option known as a hatch edit, with the help of which whatever the hatch options or hatch parameters you have set, you can also change that one. This hatch edit can also be initiated by the command that is hatch edit. You can type it and it will be executed accordingly. We can go for the two color, one color. So all the options are available. We are having the respective color set. So all the options are available accordingly, they'll be working. So we have discussed this hatching into more details. So please explore it and you'll be finding that it is amazing. Thanks for watching this video.